So you want to become a data analyst, but you're starting from scratch and have no idea where to begin? What skills and tools should you focus on? How long will it all take? And is it even possible to break into the field as a complete beginner? The answer to that last question is a big resounding yes. And I'm going to show you how. I've set out a step-by-step roadmap that'll take you from data newbie to landing your first job. Are you ready? Let's begin. Before we jump into our roadmap, think carefully about how you're going to learn data analytics. You got several options here, and it's important to find an approach that works for you. First, there's the self-taught route. This is great if you're already disciplined and you want to learn completely at your own pace. You can piece together your own curriculum using our roadmap and free resources, but just bear in mind that it's tough to really master data analytics without any structure or support whatsoever. Then you got bootcamps and online courses. These are ideal if you want a structured curriculum, feedback, and guidance from industry experts, and access to practical projects. If you're a complete beginner, this is the route I'd recommend. Just make sure you go with a credible provider that's actually worth the investment. A good course should cover all the core skills and topics we'll mention in our roadmap, with support from a mentor along the way. Another option is the traditional degree route. A solid choice if you're already at university or you're planning to go, but absolutely not necessary if you're already working and looking to switch careers. Employers will care much more about your skills and experience than a specific degree, so I'd only recommend this option if you're already set on going to school. Ultimately, the best approach depends on your budget, your schedule, and your preferred learning style. Do your research, compare several options, and use our roadmap to guide you. Whichever route you choose, there's a core set of topics, tools, and skills that you'll need to master. So what are they? Let's get going with our data analytics roadmap. Data analytics is all about working with numbers. So before you start analyzing data, you need to get comfortable with math and statistics. Of course, when you're working as a data analyst, you'll have tools to help you do the really complicated stuff. However, it's important that you understand some fundamentals. First, make sure you're familiar with descriptive statistics. This is useful for summarizing what's going on in the data. Learn things like mean, median, mode, standard deviation, and variance. You'll also want to cover probability, which is all about predicting how likely something is to happen. Learn the basic rules of probability, as well as the concepts like conditional probability and probability distributions. This will give you a strong foundation for interpreting data, identifying trends, and making predictions. Next, look at inferential statistics. This helps you draw conclusions from your data. Get comfortable with things like hypothesis testing, regression analysis, and confidence intervals. Don't worry if that sounds like a foreign language right now. It did to me also. It'll all become clear once you start learning, and there are tons of free resources out there to help you. Check out Khan Academy for a practical introduction to statistics, or StatQuest on YouTube if you're more of a visual learner. You'll find links to all the resources I mentioned in the description for this video. Once you've got a basic handle on math and statistics, you'll be ready for the next step, learning the essential tools you'll actually use in a data analyst job. So let's continue with our roadmap. Next, you're gonna learn two data analytics staples, Excel and SQL. First, Excel. You'll need to be an Excel pro for any job that involves data, so spend a few weeks getting to know the platform and practicing some basic functions. Learn how to sort and filter data within an Excel spreadsheet. Learn how to create pivot tables. Practice using both VLOOKUP and XLOOKUP functions to find specific information. And get to grips with conditional formatting to highlight trends within a dataset. As you learn Excel, you can also practice some of the statistics concepts you covered in step one, like calculating mean, median, and standard deviation, and also running a regression analysis. Check out Excel Easy for free tutorials, and use Excel Practice Online to work on practical exercises. Once you got Excel down, move on to SQL. SQL stands for Structured Query Language, don't forget that. And it's the most important skill you'll need to become a data analyst. SQL is a programming language that lets you access and analyze data that's stored in a database. A database is like a giant spreadsheet, but instead of tabs, it has tables. Every table stores different types of data, say customer data, order data, maybe product data. With SQL, you can quickly pull and analyze specific data from a database to uncover valuable insights, such as which products are selling best, or which marketing channel is bringing in the most repeat customers. You'll need a good 4 weeks or so to really get your head around SQL. Focus on the most important queries first, such as the following. Select. This lets you fetch specific data from a table. For example, all customers who signed up this month. Join. This combines data from multiple tables, say linking customers to their orders. And group by. This enables you to summarize data in a way that's meaningful. For example, counting how many orders were placed per day. You'll also want to learn subqueries, which involves using one query inside another for advanced data filtering. Use SQL Bolt to practice SQL for free. And if you're taking a data analytics course, check out any additional resources recommended by your course provider. Once you've mastered SQL and you can pull raw data, you'll need to learn how to make that data usable and understandable. So step 3 in our data analytics roadmap is all about data cleaning and data visualization. First up, data cleaning. Raw data is often a mess. It might have missing values, duplicates, inconsistent formatting, and all kinds of errors. Before you can analyze it, you need to clean it up. Start by learning basic data cleaning techniques in Excel, such as removing duplicates, handling missing values, standardizing formatting, like making sure dates, currency, and text inputs all follow the same structure, and using formulas like trim to remove unnecessary spaces and text to format data correctly. Once you're comfortable with these, you can move on to SQL-based data cleaning for larger databases. Learn how to use the where command to filter out incorrect or irrelevant data, apply case when to fix inconsistent categories, and use the trim and replace functions to clean up messy text fields. Next, data visualization. When you work as a data analyst, a big part of your job will involve turning numbers into insights and visualizing these insights in a way that's easy to understand. Learn how to create basic data visualizations such as bar charts, line graphs, and pie charts in both Excel and Google Sheets, and you better make them pretty. Once you're confident with that, move on to more advanced visualization tools like Tableau or Power BI. These tools allow you to build interactive dashboards, which are essential for helping businesses track key metrics and make data-driven decisions. A key skill here is choosing the right visualizations for the right data. For example, using scatter plots to show relationships between variables or heat maps to identify patterns in large datasets. To practice, check out Makeover Monday, a free weekly project where you can work on real-world datasets and improve your visualization skills. You can also use Kaggle to find datasets and experiment with both data cleaning and visualization. By the end of this step, you'll have a strong foundation in preparing and presenting data, key skills that every data analyst needs. By this point, you've got a solid foundation in working with data. You're comfortable using Excel, you've learned SQL to query databases, and you've practiced cleaning and visualizing data. Now it's time to take things up a notch and learn Python. Python is the most important programming language for data analysis. It's extremely powerful and it's used across many different industries. And you'll be pleased to hear, it's actually pretty easy to learn. With Python, you'll be able to automate repetitive tasks like data cleaning and reporting, perform advanced data analysis using powerful libraries like pandas and NumPy, create stunning data visualizations with matplotlib and seaborn, and even dip into machine learning, if that's something you're interested in. Plan to spend 2 to 4 months learning Python. Start by getting familiar with the basics, such as variables, loops, and functions. Then move on to data-specific tasks. Some key skills to focus on include the following. Using pandas to clean and manipulate data. For example, filtering, grouping, and reshaping datasets. Working with NumPy for numerical analysis, such as handling arrays and performing calculations. Creating data visualizations with matplotlib and seaborn, and writing basic scripts to automate tasks. Again, this might all sound like a foreign language right now. Believe me, I get it. But I promise, it'll make sense once you dive in and see for yourself. For free learning resources, check out Google's Python Crash Course or Kaggle's Python Tutorials. As always, I've added links in the video description. If you're taking a data analytics course, Python should be covered extensively in the curriculum. Once you're confident with Python, you might also want to explore R, another language used in data analytics, particularly for statistics-heavy work. But for now, focus on mastering Python. It's the best investment you can make for your data analytics career. Data analytics is a very hands-on field, and you need to get as much practice as possible. So step 5 in our roadmap is all about applying what you've learned to real-life projects. The goal here is to work with actual datasets and solve real problems. If you're taking a data analytics course, you should already have access to practical projects with the benefit of feedback. Beyond that, come up with your own projects. Pick a topic that interests you. It could be healthcare, sports, finance, whatever you like. And find open datasets online. Check data.gov or public repositories on GitHub. Once you've chosen your dataset, think about the questions you want to answer. Maybe you want to understand patterns in the data, test hypotheses, or predict future trends. It doesn't matter, as long as you're using real-world data to solve problems and practice your analysis skills. If you're stuck for project ideas, use ChatGPT to help you. Try a prompt like, what are some interesting questions I can answer using sales data? Or how about, what kind of data analysis would be useful for understanding social media trends? ChatGPT can also guide you on how to structure your analysis. This is especially useful if you're going the self-taught route and you don't have a blueprint to follow. Once you've defined your project, work through the entire data analysis process, from data cleaning and analysis through data visualization and communicating your insights. Imagine you're completing this project for a real company. Think about how you'd present your findings to your boss or your colleagues, and how you'd present the information in a meaningful and actionable way. That's a crucial part of working as a data analyst, and it's a skill that employers will be looking for. In your quest to become a data analyst, you might also want to explore machine learning and AI. This isn't strictly necessary, but it can be valuable, and it's interesting. You don't need to go too deep at this point, just start with the basics. Learn what machine learning is and how it's used in analytics. Explore simple models like linear regression and decision trees, and get to know the difference between supervised and unsupervised learning. If you want some hands-on practice, use Python libraries like scikit-learn to practice building and evaluating simple machine learning models. Once you got the skills, it's time to showcase them. So, step 7 is all about building your portfolio. A strong portfolio shows employers that you can apply data analytics in the real world. It houses practical projects you've worked on, detailing your process from start to finish. Most importantly, each project case study should clearly highlight the problem you were solving and the insights you found. You can host your portfolio on GitHub or create your own personal website. And don't worry, you can build a really strong portfolio with just 2 or 3 projects. If you're taking a data analytics course, you should get expert support with building your portfolio and structuring your case studies. It's also worth looking at existing portfolios to get a feel for how it's done in the industry. Use sites like GitHub, Kaggle, and Medium, or search for data analyst portfolio examples on the web. Happy with your portfolio? Confident in your data skills? Ooh, then you're ready for the final step in our roadmap. Let's go. This is the moment you've been working towards, applying for your first data analytics job. A strong job search category is key here. Don't just apply randomly. Look for roles that align with your skills and think about how you can leverage your previous experience. If you got a background in finance, for example, you'll have an advantage when applying to data analyst roles in that field. At this point, you should also focus on building your network. Connect with data analysts on LinkedIn, join online communities, and engage with the industry. Many jobs never even get posted online, so you need to build relationships and let people know that you're job hunting. Check the video description for some great data communities you can join. When you start getting interviews, preparation is everything. Be ready to talk about your portfolio projects, walk through your approach to solving data problems, and answer common technical questions. Use sites like SQL Zoo, Stratascratch, and Excel Easy for practice SQL and Excel challenges. And don't forget to brush up on general interview skills, like explaining your thought process clearly and concisely. Last but not least, be consistent. You're not gonna get hired overnight, and finding the right role takes time, especially when you're a newcomer. But remember that data analysts are in very high demand, and there are many companies out there who need your skills. Stick with it. You've now got a step-by-step roadmap you can follow to become a data analyst. Use it to guide your learning, evaluate data analytics courses, and use as a springboard for further research. If you want to fast-track your route into the field, I recommend taking a structured data analytics course that offers practical projects, expert guidelines, and career support, like Masterschool's Data Analytics program. And if you're based in Germany, you can apply for a voucher and have your program fully funded by the German government. You'll find the links in the description, together with a whole heap of resources that will help you on your journey to becoming a data analyst. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more content like this. Thanks so much for watching, and see you next time.